Ward's header. There's a loose one. York seizes onto it. Uses Roy Keane. Possibilities here for Manchester United. The cross partially cleared by Keogh. Anelka couldn't resist leaning into it with an arm.
Unreal. Vieira must beat your play against Martin. The amount of times you see players and they think they're past them, suddenly those long legs come out and just hook the ball away. Great quality.
And, towards Keane by Beckham from the free kick. Keane played in the semi-final here in his Nottingham Forest days, successfully against West Ham. He scored in a 4-0 try back in 91. David Ellery mentioned they're sending Roy Keane off here in 95, but he also gave Manchester United two penalties in an FA Cup final against Chelsea in 94. Happy just to help it on. Schmeichel quite happy to play it short. I'm sure that Irwin was quite so happy about that. He just shot a look back at his goalkeeper.
It's where he's less sure, Schmeichel, on that left side, Martin. He's not great with his left foot. He always tries to run round him and play him with his right if he can, or pass him like he did to Dennis.
But how well his form has returned, almost since he announced that he would be leaving Manchester United at the end of the season. Will this be his last FA Cup game?
Well, I can't believe a player of his quality and the career that he's had doesn't want to face another FA Cup semi-final, another Champions League maybe semi-final, potential final. It just seems strange that when you're built to do what he does, that you bring it to an early end.
Some variety into Manchester United's positional play by cropping up there. A touch on from Anelka, not really controlled. Beckham on the wander again. Blocked by Keown with Watt. Decision is a corner. Manchester United fans have a part of the big Holgate stand. The majority with Arsenal behind that goal, but the United contingent had a good look at this.
Yeah, it's in the arm, but I don't think he had anything to do with it. And the corner's the right decision. And we're looking for better delivery than his last one.
Well, just over half an hour play. Plenty of invention. No goals yet. And the first FA Cup semi-final today. Giggs. There's a deflection on it, but it suited David Seaman in the end. Winterburn moving more freely now. Vivas. Oh, good roll there. To ease it wide to Dixon. Well, they're grouped up defensively and Arsenal can't pick a pass through them that time. Giggs. Just seem to carry on the pace beyond where Andy Cole wanted the ball to drop. Again, the outlet for Arsenal through the right back. Bergkamp, Manchester United a little slow to react. Overmars waving Winterburn outside him so that he could go on Mark Overmars with that change of pace. And what a vital tackle for Gary Neville. If he got it wrong, it would have been a penalty. It probably would have been a sending off for him, having been booked.
Well, this is why we're 0-0, and this is why hardly any keepers had a shot to save Martin, because the quality of the defending has been absolutely top draw. Again, perfectly timed tackle from Gary Neville.
Tadding's coming in. Beckham, beaten up by Schmeichel. Ray Parlour is there. And it's Irwin who clears, as he was mown down by Adams, who apologises for the foul, which the referee spotted.
What a save, though. What a save. Time was brilliant about this. You look at the way he gets past players here, Martin. He's on his line, but look at him. By the time the shot comes in, he's 6 yards out. And had he not gone there, then Vieira just might have stuck it a right foot out and knocked it in. But he was prepared to come out, leave his line, narrow the angle. Well, he got it all right.
Your don't go Peter campaign. Dennis Irwin is staying, he's got a new contract. He's been a real star of previous semi-finals. Scored in one against his old club, Oldham. Scored here against Crystal Palace in 95. And of course, he's on penalties, I'm sure, today. He didn't play in the league game in February between these two at Old Trafford. United got a penalty, and Dwight York missed it. King misplaced the pass then. It's Winterburn. And it's well wide. Has ever taken a team five times to FA Cup finals at Wembley. Alex Ferguson will be the first if Manchester United get through this semi-final. Arsene Wenger, who has seen his side mount the challenge on the twin fronts again, try to scale the twin peaks of league and FA Cup in the same season. To do it two seasons running would be sensational. There's Johnson getting a piece of Bergkamp and the ball.
Yeah, good decision that from the referee. Yuri Johnson did clearly win the ball. That's why a throw-in was given to Arsenal.
Beckham having to defend. He's been quite happy to go down that part of the pitch to do his tackling. Ten minutes to go to half-time. Still nothing between the irresistible force and the immovable object. But gets it back from Earl. Giggs with the little touch through. Once more. Knock that up easily enough. Yeah, leading the chase against Dwight York. Played once in the semi-final for Aston Villa. He was a loser at Old Trafford. Against Liverpool. Bergkamp, has he got the acceleration? Back came Keane again. It's more with a sense of responsibility. He's always had that as a player in terms of the strategy of his football, not always in terms of his temperament, although captaining Manchester United has curbed a great deal of the previous successes.
He's done that brilliantly in the first half, Roy Keane. Been very important.
Beckham just got a yard on Winterburn here. Now, is it going to be one of the great Beckham crosses? Dixon gets his head to it. Drops for Keane. Opportunity for Gary Neville to whip it in now for Manchester United. Off Martin Keown's head, another Manchester United corner.
Well, you'd always expect, I think, Adams and Keown have positioned right, and the ball's tossed in there to win it. It's got to be more Beckham-like the cross, you know, a bit of pace, bit of bend. Gives York and Cole a better chance.
That's good for pursuing by Beckham. Giggs chasing his own touch around Dixon. Great play by Ryan Giggs. And it leads to a chance for Roy Keane. But the flag is up. It's not going to count.
I'll tell you what, Martin, that's one to debate. That's one to debate. I don't see how you can give offside here unless somebody's offside with a cross. And they can't be offside with a cross. Oh, he's offside there. I'll tell you what, the flag's gone up early, I think. Now it's gone up again. Now this flag's gone up when Ryan Giggs tucked it round the corner. It's not for the shot, it's nothing to do with that. That will be debated, and long and hard. I think it's a goal. I think it should stand. I think the linesman's got it wrong.
Well, David Ellery may not have made his final decision yet. He's pointing across to the far side, Graham Atkins, the linesman, and the referee has accepted that point of view from his assistant.
Watch this, Martin, now, as he tucks it round the defender here. Now look right in the middle here, just an 18-yard line. Now the flag's gone up. It comes down again, you'll see, but as soon as Giggs crosses, the flag goes up again, because there's nothing wrong with this goal. I think it should stand. You cannot be offside playing the ball into your own pass, and certainly whoever was central cannot be offside. He's not in the active area. I think it's a bad decision. United are furious. Dennis Irwin's just been booked. They just feel everything's going against them.
David Ellery, no stranger to semi-final controversy. Remember Chesterfield at Old Trafford 2 years ago, when the ball seemed to go over the line and a goal wasn't given. The ball certainly flew into the back of the net here, and the referee responded to what his assistant saw, flagged for, and then described to the referee.
Well, you need a bit of fortune if you're going to win the FA Cup. Arsenal have had a huge chunk there.
That's Keown's turn to look aggrieved. Free kick given against him, contact on York.
I have to say, Martin, I thought for the opening 35 minutes as well, I thought Arsenal had just shaded it. I thought they were the better, looked more likely. United, just the 2 or 3 minutes of good pressure. And that was brilliant play from Giggs. Great finish, and it's had no reward whatsoever.
Beckham with a free kick. Winterberg. Although Arsenal kept the ball, the referee wanted to make sure that Nicky Butt knew he'd spotted the foul, and I think there's so much heat in the situation that David Ellery, using his considerable experience, to try and cool it down. Nil-nil. Dixon. Parler. Well, he had Anelka with him, and Manchester United looked a bit light at the back. Bergkamp. And Keane kept him at bay. Didn't make the most of that position, Arsenal, then. Cleared by Gary Neville.
No, he didn't. I think Bergkamp's been in good possession, you know, but it's not quite happened for him yet. He's been in possession, edge of the box, last third, where you would want Dennis Bergkamp to have the ball. But Phil Marks and Manchester United have managed to close him out more often than not. Well, I didn't think this game could pick up much more, but I think with that decision, it certainly will do.
Anelka. Johnson to Schmeichel. There to help him out. Ronnie Johnson was caught in a difficult situation. Couldn't be sure exactly where his goalkeeper was, where Bergkamp was. Roy Keane hasn't scored an FA Cup goal for Manchester United for more than 5 years, and he was sure for a moment or two that he'd put that right. He was roaring off, racing away in triumph, and then he saw the flag. Manchester United fans and Arsenal fans would love Villa Park to be bigger. Capacity less than 40,000, but geographically it provides a splendid neutral ground when the London club meets the northern side.
Well,
almost
of course,
50 semi-finals here.
To fulfill demand, I guess we would, Mark, but it's still a great venue, great atmosphere around the place today.
Key. Just enough time for Dixon to squeeze it away. Bergkamp. Powell's been rather on the periphery by his standards for Arsenal. Not quite the same without Manu Petit alongside Vieira. And Powell trying to get involved more infield. And Cole did well, didn't give it up. Neville. Beckham just trying to lift it in early. He'd spotted where Andy Cole was waiting. And moving towards stoppage time. Before half-time at Villa Park. Winterburn.
Well, whereas I thought Arsenal had a good half-hour, Martin, I think United are certainly finishing the half the stronger. It's been a good last 15 minutes for the side in red.
But Dix, maybe a chance to take on Dixon. Dixon used all his know-how, that Martin Keown thought it was going to run out. Andy Cole had other ideas. He's chasing everything. Dix. But from Giggs's pass. Comes across and Nelka, they can't get it away, Arsenal, but that's a challenge into the back of Nelka by a player who's already been booked, Dennis Irwin.
Just got to be careful, referee using common sense here, comes in behind. I mean, that's probably a booking 9 times out of 10, Martin, isn't it?
I think you can remove the word probably.
And I think he's taken into account the atmosphere, what's happened. Whether he should or not, others can debate it.
And David Seaman slipped as he took that free kick. And an easy back pass for Schmeichel to deal with, although he made it look easy with a bumping volley.
Well, it's been a good half of football. We haven't had goals, admittedly, but I'll tell you what, there's been much to admire in this game so far.
Were signalled for the time to be added on. Vieira. Arsenal have settled the quicker of the two sides, there's no doubt about that, but Manchester United have picked up their game as the half has developed. York rather reflecting their current confidence with the back here. Giggs. And number seven tricking the other. Vivas getting the better of Beckham. Vivas wanting to take it on. David Ellery thought there was an advantage there. I don't really think there was. But it spares him having to make maybe a more awkward decision. Good challenge by York. Benefits Cole. Back for Dwight York. Oh, and he couldn't really dig out a shot.
No, I think he should take it onto his left
to survive again.
I think he should take this out of his feet onto his left and hit it. I think by trying to control it into his right, it gives Keown enough chance, makes the shot awkward. Whereas if you take it out onto your left side, even if it's not your strongest, just hit the thing. he can get power, he can hit the target, he can really test the keeper.
9 years here at Villa Park, Dwight York, and he's taken plenty of chances, more difficult than that one on this ground. Well, a lot of good attacking play, some fine defending, and one great debate here after 45 minutes of this FA Cup semi-final. Those arguments still going on about the disallowed goal. This is what it was all about. A case of when the flag goes up. Seemed to be that, the first point, I think you can just see it at the top of your screen. So what happened after that, in the mind of the assistant, was academic. It was a rasping shot, took a deflection on the way in from Roy Keane. United thought that they had scored, the shake of the head from David Ellery. I don't think we've heard the last of this one. But at half-time at Villa Park, it's Manchester United 0, Arsenal 0.